Navangur, who is a student of Mathamanga College by, and passing my BSc in chemistry. Here I am about to discuss some topics of green chemistry, like what is green chemistry and especially the chemistry of the sono chemistry. What is green chemistry? Green chemistry basically means to the designing of the materials in the chemicals that are better for human health, and that are better for our environment as a whole. And that will help us to design an efficient plant where we will utilize everything in sort of circular way. Everyone's life will be better. Sono chemistry is a branch of chemistry that deals with the effects of the ultrasound on chemical reaction. It acts as a non-conventional energy source. It also decreases the boiling point of the liquid. Theory of the sono chemistry. Generally, ultrasound having frequencies 20 kHz to 1 MHz are used in sono chemistry. Electromagnetic wave travel in the cam, but the mechanical wave requires an elastic medium to propagate. Ultrasound can be focused and reflected in an elastic medium. It propagates in a medium like sound waves. Both the lengthwise and transverse wave can be transmitted. But in solid and but in liquid and gaseous medium, only lengthwise wave can be transmitted. Like sound waves, it also causes compression and rarefaction, which create alternative zones of high pressure and low pressure. Low pressure zones create a cavity which suddenly bubbles in a compression zone. This phenomenon is known as cavitation. The direct interaction between the reactant and the wave is not possible. To induce a chemical reaction, but the air indirect interaction known as cavitation acts as a relay to induce a chemical reaction. Owing to the widespread use of ultrasonic cleaning bath, it is not surprising that many early ultrasonic experiments were directed at the reactions where dirty metal surfaces were thought to be cause of inefficiencies. Simon Smith reactions are often not predictable or sometimes require a long induction period followed by the violent exotherm. Jeten was sonochemically activated to react with CH2I2 to produce carbonoid, which reacts with the carbon to produce cyclopropane derivative. In this reaction, if we use ultrasound, then 91% yield no exotherm, no iodine. If we do not use ultrasound, then 51% yield unpredictable exotherm with iodine.